Direk Erik Matti on what he discovered about Kuwaresma, lead star Sharon Cuneta, leaving Darna. It took 2 long months of convincing before filmmaker Erik Matti, director of the horror mystery film Kuwaresma, finally agreed to sit down with the Inquirer Entertainment team. I really don't like press cons. People ask you questions, but when you try to read your answers, you find that it's just one short sentence, Matti pointed out during a recent interview held at the Inquirer office in Makati City. Lasting for almost an hour and a half, including the session that he wanted off the record. The interview was attended by representatives of various platforms of the Inquirer Group of Companies. The director was strong, brave and bold, much like the characters in the movies he creates when he answers the questions thrown at him, be it about his views on politics, his controversial decision to quit Darna, his thoughts on Kuwaresma lead actress Sharon Cuneta, his bashers, and even his fellow independent filmmakers. He definitely deserves more than just a one-sentence quote. Excerpts from our chat, then, midway into preparing, Donovan, Monteverdi, producer, had an idea. What if we cast these names? Let's try Sharon, Cuneta. I thought, will she accept this? She doesn't do horror. Besides, horror is tedious, with so much camera coverage. To our surprise, Sharon said, nobody knows this, Direk, but I'm the biggest fan of horror movies. True enough, she can throw the lines of Linda Blair in the classic horror film, The Excerpts. Make a capture work. This project that looks like something that will show Sharon in a different light. Definitely. I've worked with her in advertising and everyone sees her as an icon, a star. To find out that she loves horror, and is willing to do something like this is awesome. To hear that Sharon, a big star, is willing to do everything that the material demands of her is a big deal. There's something about your productions that draw the attention of big stars, like John Lloyd Cruz, Anne Curtis, Paolo Pascal and Gerald Anderson. I'm just lucky. I'm not known for being an actor's director, but I challenge my actors by encouraging them to contribute to the development of their characters. That more than the dialogue, the nuance of the actor, creates the character. Natu Chiroko with Sharon and John, Arsenla, her foster in Kuwaresma. There's a scene that we wrote while we were already on the set because I realized I didn't have a dramatic scene between Sharon and John. I said, you have two big, talented actors Trapo Cindy Seelan with Katita Nav, Nav Drama? That will be like Al Pacino with Robert Niro, in the Godfather series, Nav, Dai Mo Kina Kako. And Kanga Mo Namang Director, Laugh. We shot the scene for 2 days. The script was 8 pages long, with lines running up to 4 pages. Of course they enjoyed it because they were such good actors. Sharon, at one point, confessed that she got so scared of John, who is always very intense, very organic. It's a really emotional scene. You once said that only bad movies make money. In Kuwaresma, you have a good director and 2 good actors. Do you think it will make money, because it is presumably a good movie? I'm actually scared. We've invested so much in this movie. We worked on this for 28 days. We're doing a big promotional stint on this because we want to give this movie a chance. When I posted something about movies not making money anymore, most of the comments I got were, Ang Tangit Kain Caligula. Ang Chi. Or Wallen Bagong Twento. So now, we have a new, original story, one that is not based on The Conjuring. It's very Filipino. We paid so much to get the best talent to be part of it. We didn't scrimp on production money. Now, I hope people would go and watch. We hope that they feel that we're trying to make an event movie out of this Idanaean Panaman left square bracket Namalapit right square bracket saw Mother's Day Ang opening. What really happened while you were still in charge of Darna? I was with Darna for 5 years. We introduced a lot of characters, old and new. We had a hard time putting that together. I said I was ready to complete the movie after 5 years, but if there's going to be more waiting, if there are still adjustments, then I'd have to move on. They say this particular Darna project is cursed. What do you think is the reason it's not pushing through? I think they're banking on it as a flagship project. They're making sure it goes well with the branding of ABS-CBN. I'm thinking that just so Renila could end on Sobra. But with Darna, there's pressure to come up with a superhero movie that goes with modern times. I mean, we have to take into consideration products from Marvel and DC Comics. With the audience seeing superhero films every other month, people are bound to compare your product not just in terms of aesthetics, but also theme and story. Since this is a reboot, it's better achieve a young and fresh face. I'm thinking 21 years old. Were you able to turn Lisa Soderno into a plain-looking girl? Who? Hiro Kei Hyperio Kei. She lives in the slum area, Hiro, Daido Mushandika. It has aesthetics, lass. On a lighter note, we heard that you will be doing something for HBO. What is this? HBO Asia has a series airing now called Folklore, which is an anthology horror series. They have directors from 8 different countries. It's a strong series, so they came up with Food Lore, which is about the food of each country. Mine is a dramatic story of an OFW. Our consultant is Margarita Ford, of SIBO, because we're both Ilongo, and I want to feature Ilongo food. In the meantime, I'm resuming the food of OTJ too. We've partnered with Hook and Glows. They've agreed that we will first join an international festival, like in Toronto, before releasing it locally. This goes straight to OTT, over the top, streaming for Southeast Asia under Hook. What's the next OTJ about? Dennis Trillo said he badly wanted to work with you. Dennis is an underrated actor. I believe he needs a lot more exposure in terms of films. He is a silent worker. He doesn't have to prove anything. OTJ2 may be my last political movie, for now. I'm moving towards more story-driven films. I'm not trying to be a Lino Braga. My movies don't try to lecture the audience. They always present things on both sides. One day, he goes to the office and discovers that all of them disappeared. So now, the compromised journalist starts becoming the journalist that he used to be. He is up hesitant as to who is to blame for what happened to his colleague. And cornering by the man Warren Baden-Dooney. It's unrealistic. At the same time, I don't want a villain without humanity. I always make movies that are grounded on those things. Your thoughts on them? Metro Manila Film Festival. Sadly, we're back to this really senseless ruling. No one in his right mind could justify why there are two submissions. That is made at half-mass scripts and at half-mass finished films. That's unfair business practice because the first four finalists will already have left for promo even before the cameras start grinding. The other four will be announced at a time that's closest to the festival run. It's a festival with no integrity. Do you think online platforms contribute to the low box office turnout? That's one issue we're tackling with the cinema owners now. We've had a series of meetings already with the cinema owners. One of the issues raised was that the audience no longer feels forced to go to the cinema to watch because, a month later, the movie can be seen online or in other platforms. They're asking its producers to extend the holdback period to between 4 and 6 months. We're willing to give them 5 months because we feel that the cinema operators have a point. Do you think it's okay to move the opening of movies from Wednesday to Friday? The cinema operators said we're not sure if it's going to help, but we're okay with Friday if that's what you want. Warren Pangolin shot Sinhan until Sunday, Kei Kun, Guy Maiman Upper Ankalagas, Malalaman Monabiden. We also said that by Monday, Lad Maiman Silang Matangal Nang Hindi Kina Kautapang producers. This is because we sometimes expect word of mouth. What's good about what happened was that, now, it's not only two parties talking. Also involved are the DTI, Department of Trade and Industry, DIL, Department of Interior and Local Government, and Bender, Salvador, Hainlo, Presidential Spokesperson. How is your partnership with your wife, screenwriter Michiko Yamamoto, like? How do you influence each other in terms of artistry? we started working together in On the Job. At the time, she was writing another movie. I said, what heyo? Esa info, mansa, yo. Read mine. She said, okay, I'll put order into it. It works. When she writes it, I know that I will be able to shoot it. Do you fraternize with fellow directors, much like the directors club of Steven Spielberg, Martin Scorsese, Frank Ford Coppola, etc. Every other week, I have drinks with some of them. I invite a good mix of male and female directors. Filipino filmmakers aren't the type who will tell you straight out how they feel about your work. In that Maverick group you've mentioned, Spielberg wouldn't ask everyone to watch Close Encounters of the Third Kind. After the screening, he said, when a director suggests a scene to be taken out because it's bad, it's probably the best scene in the movie. Ninjita Rosa Hate I Feel It. Slash. Left square bracket Brian right square bracket comma asks him, why are you doing a movie about aliens when there's enough stories about people? Hustle is becoming the biggest blockbuster. People actually listen to you. Do you use your influence to encourage people to support a political group or candidate? I rant against someone or something simply because I'm angry. But I don't have any political agenda. Everything I post on social media is personal. Besides, I'm doing a lot of things these days, so that is named in a coma to be by the hand. Right now, I'm only going for senatorial candidates, Chel Diogo, and maybe, Miri Kumner. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.